In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the Site Administration section of your private label site. You'll learn where to go to customize the look of your site, delete a wiki, create user accounts, and more. To begin, I make sure I'm logged in as the site administrator of my private label site. From the Home Wiki, I click the Site Administration link in the Action menu. That takes me to my site's administrative dashboard. Here I get an overview of the activity across my site, including a summary of new users, recent page edits, recently created wikis, and more. It's a good place to visit if I want to get a sense of the overall activity on my site. Next, I have the Wikis button. Here I can easily find and manage my wikis. I can search for a specific wiki, or review all the wikis on my site. Once I've found the wiki I want, I can visit it, rename it, or delete it. On this page, I can also create wiki templates that will let me easily recreate wikis that I already know are successful. Then I head to the Users button to manage all the user accounts on my site. As with the wikis, I can also search for a specific user. If I follow the username, I can manage that user's settings. I can also select multiple accounts and either delete them, suspend them, or upgrade them to the role of site administrator. Further down this page, I have options to create user accounts in bulk and to email my users. The Settings button lets me manage all my site-wide settings. Here, I can set up permissions for my site, customize my site's look and feel, integrate my site with other services like Moodle, LDAP, or Google Apps, set up a custom domain, and more. The last button in Site Administration leads to the subscription page. Here I can make a payment for my site, change or upgrade my subscription plan, or generate an invoice. And that's just a brief introduction to your site administration tools. The better you get to know them, the more you can do with your private label site.